Oh no, someone is talking on the YouTubes. As my five-year-old says, boring. Pay attention, you might learn something. What is the ECM style? ECM is a European record label, but it's captured so much of this style of music from the 70s onward that the label has become synonymous with the musical style known as ECM. It's difficult to put into words, so if you have no idea what I'm talking about, check out Questar by Keith Jarrett. Similar to how jazz is an amalgamation, did he just say amalgamation of European and African music, ECM is a fusion of various styles as well, including early rock grooves like boogaloo, jazz, and Brazilian music. Think samba and bossa nova. So how did it evolve? Well, in the late 1950s, it was very common to stick with a static groove, only interjecting every so often with the snare kick. Check out Joe Morello with Dave Brubeck, or Jimmy Cobb on Kinda Blue. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Many drummers, you know, the ones that like to work and play gigs for a living, they play like that all day. All day. Typically, that's what the music needs. So by all means, play that groove. The jazz drummers of the 60s, the unruly and rambunctious bunch that they were, they had begun to move away from those more conventional styles of playing. I'm talking about Paul Motion, Tony Williams, Jack DeJohnette, Roy Haynes, Elvin Jones, and many others who evolved and expanded the role of the drum set by utilizing a more open or broken approach. The concept of open or broken means that each limb can be utilized independently to compose a free-flowing stream of melodic ideas. This freed them up to allow more space in the music.
Space. The final frontier.
They could also generate more energy at times because they weren't confined to a particular convention. It's out of this evolution where drummers assumed more responsibility for their improvisational contribution to the music from which the ECM style emerged. Check out Billy Higgins on Sidewinder. Watermelon Man, for that boogaloo feel that was ubiquitous in the early 60s. And then, listen to Tony Williams on Cantaloupe Island, 81, in Maiden Voyage. Dig how they alternate the straight eighth groove with a swing groove on 81. When you tell a drummer like Tony Williams to play some of that boogaloo, well, he's gonna open it up a bit. And them jazz roots is strong, so when Miles starts swinging those lines, you jump in and start swinging with him. You can hear how the ECM style was emerging as a straight eighth version of the open and more melodic comping styles of the legendary jazz drummers of the mid-60s. When I play jazz drums, everything starts with the ride cymbal. The ride cymbal is the king of the north.
The king in the north!
Everything needs to more or less lock in with the ride cymbal when I'm comping. We just want to even out that feel, so we're playing straight eighths. Mm-hmm. Up-tempo swing is really similar to ECM straight eighth style because as you play faster, the eighth notes even out. So I approach an up-tempo swing groove the same way as an up-tempo ECM groove, except the hi-hat lands a little differently and my body moves a little differently. It can be a subtle difference. And keep in mind the Brazilian influence on this style. Sometimes an up-tempo ECM is sort of like a loose samba. It's difficult to put into words, but listen to the music and play along as much as possible. I hope this video inspires you to dig deeper into the ECM style. For further listening, check out Jan Christensen, Bob Moses, Paul Huertico, Jorge Rossi, Bill Stewart, and Jeff Ballard. Boring! Boring.